hate if it's a drama, just say.
It's not a drama. You'll get your money, okay? Do you want it in writing?
Relax. I just want to know when.
We're moving off of this gear.
How much?
150. It's stainless steel, mate. One off.
Rip off.
By the time we're moving off of this gear, I'll be in a retirement home. It's a joke, mate. Okay, I'm joking. Mate, if we don't do something radical, we are going to go seriously broke. Why don't we start a fishing charter business?
We know nothing about fishing.
What's to know, mate? Look, we get a boat, take people out with a few rods.
Cross, what's up? Okay. Yeah, I'm coming. Nothing, I'm fine. I'll see you in 10.
Single shot, Mackay?
Yep, high-powered rifle by the look of it. Back of his head's blown off.
It's broad daylight, should be plenty of witnesses.
That takes big balls.
Or no brains.
Or both. It's every guy I've ever met. Present company excluded.
Well, you never can be too sure, Mackay.
Got two witnesses. Reckon the shots came from across the road somewhere.
Yeah, well, that makes sense. The bullet went through the top of his skull.
Why don't you two check out the buildings across the road then?
See if we get a clear line of sight?
Yeah.
You got it, Big Nuts.
Big Nuts, eh?
She's obviously a deeply intuitive woman.
Did I just say what I think I said to a superior officer?
Yes, you did.
Hey, Muzz. Hey. I'm just going to ask you a couple of questions, is that okay?
Sure.
How long had you and Ben been working here?
Been working the market about 3 years. Benny's an artist.
Is there anyone that you can think of that may have a grievance towards Ben? Like friends, family, business associates?
No. He was just a great guy. Everyone loved him. Everyone. It's like losing a brother.
Sorry.
Okay, so we've got a clear line of sight here. We should check the surveillance.
Don't touch the ledge. Could be gunshot residue.
So, how'd you get on with that guy last night?
So if the shooter was here, firing with a high-powered rifle, shell casing would have ejected this way.
I think he would have picked it up.
Unless he was in a hurry. Which, conveniently for us, looks like he was.
Yeah, that's got to be the guy. He's coming out of the building where we found the shell.
And he's wearing a long sleeve shirt when it's 30 degrees out.
Big balls, no brains.
And bloody ordinary surveillance footage at that.
Black and white analogue camera, 0.3 megapixel. At least 15 years old, it's garbage.
Did the witness statements turn up any leads?
A couple of passers-by mentioned that they saw the victim and his friend arguing about money. But nothing on the shooter.
I got a lead for you. That shell casing's from a 5.56 mil Thales bullet, manufactured exclusively for the Australian Defence Forces for use in Steyr assault rifles, which are also manufactured for the ADF. So we're looking for a bloke with access to military hardware and bad taste in knitwear.
Has that come back from ballistics already?
No, boss. 12 years in the Army Reserve.
Here's our boy. Little birdie told me you got a birthday coming up.
Apparently so.
One of the big ones, the little birdie said.
After 25, they're all big. Tell the little birdie that.
Hey, Mars, how you going, mate? How you feeling today?
Didn't sleep too much, but, you know, a good surf helps.
Yeah, I find a good surf always clears the head.
Mars, we're just wanting to ask you a few quick questions. Did Ben have any friends or family that worked in the armed forces?
No way. He's got a sister in Hobart and his dad's in England. And friends? Can't say it. Ben was a greenie, didn't even like war movies.
What about you?
Nah. Why, what, did someone in the army kill Benny?
Well, we're not quite sure yet.
Apparently, Ben owed you some money.
Yeah, $2,000. So what?
Well, what did he need it for?
He had to get his car fixed because the cops defected it.
Do you know if that's what he actually spent it on?
I never asked. When your best mate says he needs cash, you just give it to him, don't you?
Yeah, you do.
So, do you always give your friends cash when they ask for it?
Nope, I don't have any.
What's that, cash or friends?
Both.
Where are you? So, are you coming to my surprise birthday party?
Absolutely, Tully. Wouldn't miss it for the world, Tully. When is it?
I don't know. You'll have to ask Mackay.
Oh, it's a forensic surprise to boot.
Mm-hmm. It's nice and all, but I'd rather my birthday just be no fuss.
Did I?
Tully? Uh-huh. Great. All right, thank you. Okay, so Muzz's story about the D notice on Ben's car checked out.
Okay. Didn't want to kill a jewelry-making greenie with no criminal connections and no money.
Some random nutbag with no motive.
There's always a motive, Tully, even if it's just to get your face in the papers.
I'm hungry. Do we get some tea?
Move back! Let these people back! Let them all back!
Sir, is that your car? Is anyone in the car? Are you the driver? Do you know what happened?
Mom, my car
is near the car when it exploded. What?
Move back,
we're near the car when it exploded. Look at me, look at me.
Oh, it's right here. I got in the car and then I realised I left my wallet in the shop. So I got out again and...
Did you turn the ignition on?
Hey?
The ignition in the car, did you turn it on?
Sorry, I got the springing in my ears.
It's okay, mate, it's okay.
What?
Get him some water.
It doesn't matter.
Sit him down, I think his ears.
Make sure you look after him until the ambulance comes. Get him some water. Jesus. Bomb squad's on its way.
It smells like RDX wax.
What the hell's that?
Explosive used in F1 hand grenades. Okay, we've got two attacks using 80th military hardware in the last 2 days. Got to be more than a coincidence, boss.
Is there any connection between the kid who was shot and the guy whose car was bombed?
Nothing so far.
Okay, we'll keep searching. Cross-check friends, family, workplaces. See if you can find anything that's going to put these two guys in the same frame.
What about the young mate of the bloke who was shot?
Murray Taylor. Friends refer to him as Muzz.
See if he can ID the car bomb victim Tanner on a photo parade. That might give us a connection.
There is one surveillance camera in the street where the car blew up, and guess what? It's broken.
Just the way we like it.
I know.
Get onto the Defence Department. Get the details of any bloke who's been discharged from the armed services on psychological grounds in the last 6 months.
Yep.
I'm going to have a cup of coffee with my brother-in-law.
What sort of weapons were used in the commission of these crimes?
Steyr assault rifle using 5.56 ball ammunition and an F1 fragmentation grenade. They're all still current ADF issue, yeah?
Indeed. Thank you.
Thank you. So, you've been an army psychiatrist and everything. I figured you might know a few blokes who fit the profile.
Sadly, Max, I suspect that the number of military personnel with a predilection for this kind of aberrant behaviour is far greater than anyone would care to admit.
So that's a no, is it?